Notice up until now in our sketching, we've only taken a look at the line arc tool and the spline tool. But we can see below these we have a number of other very useful tools for creating specific commonly used objects. So, for example, let's first take a look at using the rectangle tool. Now, of course, I can just use my line arc tool to sketch out a rectangle, and I would just do that by just sketching out 4 lines, something like this. And notice, of course, that wasn't very difficult and was actually pretty nice and easy, but if we wanted to, we also have the rectangle tool, which can sketch out that rectangle even faster and more efficiently. So to use the rectangle tool, I can just tap on that rectangle to select. And notice I have the drop down here as well. So I have 3 different rectangular types I can create: center, diagonal, and 3 points. And also notice in the icons themselves, we have these blue dots that help show you where you need to tap to draw the rectangle. So for center, for example, the blue dot is in the center of my rectangle. So let's start with center here. And I can just tap once to start the center of my rectangle and then drag my pencil out. And notice that's creating any shape rectangle I may want. Also notice that since I use the center rectangle, I have an X about my center point there, and that's the anchor point of this rectangle. And what that means is that if I were to change any dimension, let's say I change this from 6 millimeters to 8 millimeters, notice the center point there did not move, as it's the anchor point. Similarly, if I change this dimension here to say 14 millimeters, again, notice my center point or anchor point did not move. And very similar idea for my other types of rectangles. I'll just show the diagonal here. And now I just tap down to start my rectangle and drag for the other diagonal of my rectangle. And again, notice in the top left corner of this rectangle, I see that X or that anchor point. And same exact idea if I were to change any dimensions now of this rectangle. Let's say make this 12 millimeters. Notice that top left corner did not move, as that's my anchor point. Same idea here if I change the bottom dimension, let's say 15 millimeters. And again, the top left corner did not change its location. The circle tool works in a very similar way. I can just tap to start my circle tool, tap once to the center point of the circle, and drag out to size my circle however I would like. The ellipse tool works very similar to the circle tool, so I'll jump into my ellipse tool. Start from its center, tap down, and drag out to start my ellipse. And now what's nice here is not only can I change the 2 dimensions of my ellipse there, but I can also rotate the ellipse. So if I just tap to select this outer point of my ellipse here, and now I can rotate my ellipse as needed. Finally, we have the polygon tool, and this one is very useful for creating some more complex shapes. So if I just go into the polygon tool, again, I have a drop down here as well. So I have a number of different polygon types I can choose. Let's start with pentagon here. And again, same idea, just tap down to start my polygon at the center point, and then drag my pencil to create a polygon. And what's nice about this is I can change the dimension to change the size of my polygon, but I also have an option to change the number of sides. So notice that this currently is a pentagon, so it has 5 sides, but if I'd like, I can change this to be really any number of sides I may want. So maybe I want a polygon with 10 sides, let's say. And now we see I've very quickly created a fairly complex shape of a polygon with 10 sides here. And of course, we have a number of options for my polygon type, but they all work in a very similar way. Quickly, maybe I'll just create a triangle here, and it's really just the exact same thing to create my triangle there as well. So as we can see, all of these shapes can be created just by using our standard line arc sketch tools. However, these additional tools just give us a much quicker and more efficient way to create some very commonly used shapes.